गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू नो सेकेंड लेसन. व्हाट इज आवर सेकेंड लेसन? स्पॉट्स एंड स्ट्राइप्स. सो बिफोर गोइंग टू द टॉपिक, वी नो व्हाट आर द स्पॉट्स एंड व्हाट आर द स्ट्राइप्स. सो डू यू ऑब्जर्व इन आवर सराउंडिंग्स ऑल एनिमल्स आर सेम? नो, डिफरेंट डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ एनिमल्स. सो एनिमल्स दे आर हैविंग सो मेनी डिफरेंस. सो हियर सी, व्हाट इज दिस एनिमल? पपी. इट हैज स्पॉट्स. ओके, डू यू ऑब्जर्व चीता? इट हैज स्पॉट्स. ओके, एंड हियर सी, what is this animal? Zebra. Okay, it has stripes. Okay, the zebra has stripes. So now we know the difference of the spots and stripes. What are the spots? Like dogs, we can observe some animals like cheetah and puppy. Okay, and giraffe. Do you observe giraffe? It has some spots on their bodies. Okay, we can call that one spots. Here see giraffe, it has the stripes. Okay, so we can call stripes. So now we are going to our topic. First we have pep activity. Okay, here see pep activity 2.1. Look at your textbook, page number 17. Identify the animals and pick out suitable words for each from the help box. Write them in the blanks. Why they are given here this activity? Just we have to compare the animals. Okay, different types of animals we can observe. So we have to compare the animals. What type of features they are having and what are the difference they are having. So here see, first one they are given polar bear, and here peacock and swan, fish, tortoise and elephant. So here they are given some words. Just now I am reading these words. Look at your textbook. Trunk, shell, fins, wings, land, feathers, snow, grass, insects, worms, fish, beak, water, fly, speed. So these words, how we have to fill here? I will explain it to you. You have to write remaining. Okay, children. First one, see polar bear. So they are given two blanks. So what are the words which is suitable for us? It has trunk? No. It has wings? No. Snow. Any related word to the polar bear? Snow? Yes. Because polar bear, they can live in snow places. Do you observe? So now we have to write snow. And next one, worms. It can eat worms? No. And water? Yes. Polar bear, they can live in water and land. So now we have to write water. And next one, shell. It has shell? No. And land? Yes. The polar bear, they can live on land. Land. And grass. It can eat grass? No. And it can eat fish? As polar bears, they can eat fish. So now we write fish. And fly. It can fly? No. And fins. It has fins? No. It has feathers? No. It eats insects? No. It has beak? No. It is swim? S. Polar bears, they can swim in water also. Okay, so here I am given related answers. Okay, what are the words which is suitable for the polar bear? I am writing here. Okay, just look at once. And next one, what is this pig? Peacock. Okay, now we had to observe peacock. Peacock has turn? No. Wings? Yes. So now we have to write. And snow? No. Worms? Worms means small insects. Peacock, they can eat worms. Okay. Now, it is in water? No. It has shell? No. It is in land? Yes. Land. And next one. It can eat grass? No. It can eat fish? Yes, sometimes. And it can fly? No. And it has wings? No. And it has feathers? Yes. And it eats insects? Yes. It has beak? Yes. It can swim? No. Beak. So how many words you are having in this? You have to write. So how many words it is related to these animals? You have to write in the blanks. Just I am writing here polar bear and peacock. So now we have to write swan and fish, tortoise and elephant. Okay children, now you will understand this pep activity 2.1. What are the suitable words that are having these animals? You have to write in the blanks. Okay children, see, after completing of these words, you have to write here their given question. Which words did you link with more than one animal? Which words do you link? For example, every animal is having some related words. So here, any related words there? Yes, land. Okay, and anything? No. So these are the related words. So after completion of your answers for these all animals, you have to check out how many words, which words did you link with more than one animal. You have to write here. Okay children, after that, now open page number 18. See, choose any two animals from the given pictures. Write two common features and two features that are different between them. You have to choose any two animals from here. Your wish. Okay, you have to choose any two animals, but you have to write common features. Like this. Here, I am taking polar bear and peacock. Any common features there here? Yes, both are living on the land. So that is the one common feature. And any different features they are having? Yes, it can swim, but it has feathers. So that is the different features. It can eat, it can live on snow, but peacocks they come. So that are the different features. So here you have to write common features and different features. Okay, here you have to write common features and here you have to write different features. Okay, now we have to know diversity. Okay, students. So now we have to know diversity. What is the diversity? See here, animals we are observing in our surroundings, we have found so many animals. Okay, so in our world, we have to observe different types of animals in a world. So they range from small and to huge elephant. So each of these animals, they are different from one another. For example, see the differences of these two animals. This is the puppy and this is the zebra. Any differences there? Yes, so many differences there. It is a small animal and it is a big animal. They are looking different and they are moving different. They are eating different food items. They may be different based on the way to look and move and eating. Where they can live such wide range of differences is known as diversity. Okay children, now you know the diversity. So we are observing different types of differences on the animals, like the way of looking and the way of eating, the way of moving. So such a wide range of differences we can call diversity. Okay children, now up to now you know the stripes and spots and stripes, and you know the differences of the animals, and you know the definition of the diversity. Okay, children. So you have to complete that 2.1 activity. First question and second question today itself, and after you have to send. Okay. So tomorrow session we have to discuss the places of living animals. Okay, different places they can live. So what is our second chapter? Spots and stripes. You know the differences of the spots and stripes. Okay, children. So tomorrow I will ask these questions and I will say in the next session. Okay, until bye.